We have a battery backup system that I want to show you guys. This person actually got the fire equity resilience rebate, $54,000 rebate in this case for this size batteries and stuff. So it's a really big whole house home battery backup system that, you know, not many people are able to do or just don't do because of the cost. But with this huge rebate, it makes sense and it works great, especially with the solar. So you can see the solar on the roof there. And then we'll go check out the Sol-Ark inverters and batteries as well, and then operation. So what we got going here is just finishing this installation. Still have a little bit of wiring to do and stuff, but got the Sol-Ark inverters with Fortress battery. Now typically you probably just have one Sol-Ark inverter and maybe one Fortress battery. This is 18.5 kilowatt hours and this is a 12 kilowatt inverter. So this thing will do about 50 amps of backup power. So two of them, you got 100 amps of power. That's like, you know, 5 Tesla Powerwalls, for example. Now these are getting somewhat common for preppers, and you know, a lot of times when other battery systems can't handle the power of homes, then they put the Sol-Arks in here. And Fortress battery is a really good lithium iron phosphate battery as well. So it's got more charges and discharges, and also can't catch fire or explode or anything like that. So it's a pretty safe battery, kind of the standard in home backup batteries. And so the reason we have such a kind of a big system, this is about 55 kilowatt hours total and 24 kilowatt of inverters. It's about a 10 kilowatt PV system that we have on the roof. And we wanted to do a decent amount of batteries here because this qualified. This is a fire zone that we're in here in Southern California, and they have a well pump and it qualified for the SGIP equity resilience rebate. So he's getting about a $54,000 rebate. It's crazy. So, you know, and that's based on your battery capacity, also kind of your inverters too, but mainly battery capacity, and also that the inverters can turn that well pump on, so he can have that when there's a fire and they need to shut the power off. That's kind of the reason for that rebate and the qualifications. There's other qualifications as well, but it is pretty strict. You know, there's not that many people that will qualify for this huge rebate versus the normal 20 cent a watt rebate. So this system is gonna be able to run this guy's whole house, his well pump, his air conditioner, heat pump, everything. So it's pretty crazy. So we'll show you a little bit more details on it. Okay, so got this Sol-Ark opened up. Well, still gotta wire it and everything, but you have your different internal breakers in here connecting to the AC, you know, your main panel, and then DC to solar. So our solar is going to be in there, and you can see there grid, generator, and load. So this can auto start a generator too, which is really cool. So if you don't have enough solar power or enough battery power, or you're out for a long time, you know, you could actually have a generator kick on and help boost to power that as well. So it's like an all-in-one unit that does pretty much everything. Got a super cool app and AI system, we'll show you that. And just a lot of options with it. And then our battery here, 18.5 kilowatt hours. So what that kind of means in simple terms is like a normal track house, you know, is using about 20 to 40 kilowatt hours a day. And so 18.5, you know, in backup mode, you're gonna be able to be pretty comfortable, especially when you have solar going at the same time, providing, you know, maybe 5 to 10, or well, providing around 15 to 30 kilowatt hours that day as well. This battery will last pretty much normal use almost all day, but with the solar, fairly easily all day for a typical house, even in off-grid backup mode. And then when you got three of these, you're definitely gonna be fine, and it'll do, you know, for larger usage and larger homes and well pumps and stuff like that, and possibly even, you know, 3 to 5 days with rain and no solar, you're still gonna be okay with your batteries with a big battery system like this. So with the big rebate, you know, that's why with one, if you only do one of these, your rebate's only gonna be about $17,000. So with three of them, it's $54,000 with this particular rebate, which isn't gonna last much longer. So by the time a lot of people see a video like this, you know, the money will already be gone. So it's too late, but there might still be a chance actually if you look into this soon. So yeah, the battery, you know, is gonna be connected here. Everything's connected together and it's all tied in to to the main panel and powering the whole house, air conditioners, well pump and everything. So air conditioning isn't a very common thing with home battery backup, actually. You know, you need a pretty big system to do that because they're not made to have to be on battery backup. And even if they are, they're gonna drain the batteries pretty quickly still. You know, when you're running your air conditioner's full blast for a while, if you're off-grid. So we got a 9 kilowatt PV system up on this roof. That's gonna be charging the batteries, powering this customer's house, and you know, making everything work together and save them a lot of money on their electric bill. So combined with the rebate that they got, you know, this system ended up being really affordable, saves them a lot of money on their electric bill in Southern California, and they can go off grid too. And to be honest, this system is kind of so robust that they could probably just disconnect from Edison if they wanted to. But I don't really recommend that unless you also have a generator, also a pretty good size, you know, automatic generator. Because what might happen is, you know, you have problems with your PV system or your battery system or your inverters or anything. It's not just like, oh, my, you know, system went down, I need to call, or my bill's higher this month. You know, it's, I have no power at my house, I can't do anything. And it might be like 2 or 3 a.m. trying to contact, you know, a contractor or electrician or something to figure out what's going on. So if you do go completely off grid, which almost nobody does, I mean, it's not a very common thing yet. I think it will get more common in the future once we get to more battery generator parity where the cost kind of makes sense. And with a rebate like this, it's kind of there. But then you would want to do a generator too in case something does happen, just for an additional second backup. Right now, the grid is your additional backup. So you could just actually stay connected and just pay that minimum fee and not really use the grid. But you actually save more money using the grid, because now your batteries are discharging during the higher rates, and you're using power from the batteries during that time, and then they're charging during the lower rates. So it's kind of like energy arbitrage, like playing the stock market, buying low and selling high. So, you know, that saves you additional money and more than makes up for that $10 a month service fee that you might have on your electric bill. So it works really good, you know, taking advantage of the utility company actually and the rebate altogether. So I just wanted to mention too, normally these Sol-Ark inverters here would actually be against this back wall. And that would be fine, there's space for that and everything. But the reason we put this Unistrat here and put them on that is because there's a national electric code, like 110.26, that you can't have an obstruction more than 6 inches, you know, kind of interfering with an electrical component. So kind of annoying little code, probably would have gotten away with it, but we didn't want to have to rewire everything just in case and move it all. So we went ahead and just put it on this mount, so you only got 6 inches where the Fortress batteries are in front of the Sol-Ark inverters. So they're real easy to access. It'd be no problem to access them right there too, but that's just, you know, the way code is and stuff you gotta do sometimes to manage it. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I hope you guys learned something about kind of a really big, robust home battery backup system that can do your whole house. You know, it's not super common, but the nice thing is with this fire equity resilience rebate in Southern California right now, we're doing a lot of them, and I'm helping a lot of people out do these systems, and it pretty much covers the cost of the huge batteries. So join us next time. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel, and see you guys later.